Okay, this is how it all started. I got an email from the people at Camp Pinnacles. Camp Pinnacles is a 2-day lab in nature for kids, aged kindergarten through 8th grade. And so I met with the E-Cube Foundation, the Pinnacles Partnership, and the Arts Council of San Benito County, and they asked me if I would do an art component for the camp. And so the park had actually been thinking more along the lines of painting and drawing, and I thought, wow, if we're going to be in nature, wouldn't it be cool if we could do nature art? Kind of like Andy Goldsworthy. And so I thought, wouldn't it be great if we could do a labyrinth? And so I talked to them about it, and they said yes. So we did a site survey on March 1st, and then on June 1st, we started the project. And this is what we built. Okay, so here's how it looked on March 1st when we went in the dead of winter. And this is how it looked when we arrived on June 1st. Everything was green, lush, tons of water. I have to tell you, I couldn't have done this whole project without Isla Foley. Isla was there from the very beginning, worked hard every single day, and had great design input. Thank you, Isla! Okay, here's how we started. First, we staked out a grid. Then we laid out the stones so that they just have a basic map with which to follow. I didn't care if they stayed in the lines. As long as they started creating, that was fine with me. I didn't get a lot of pictures from this very first group because everything was so new to me. At the end of each session, I gave the kids blank journals so that they could draw or write about their experiences. Didn't take long, and then the second group of 67 K through 3rd graders came, and they added an interesting touch to the labyrinth. They were all about details and started adding all sorts of new materials to the labyrinth. Moss, sticks, all kinds of cool things, and the labyrinth grew. One of the most profoundly beautiful experiences I had with this entire labyrinth construction was watching how when the children wanted to get a large boulder, they would all gather together, and several of them would dig around the large boulder until they got just the right one. It was awesome. So now it's starting to look like a tiki torch. And in fact, one of the kids wanted to light them all on fire. I told him we couldn't do that. But this one gal created a gate with her moss stick. And then from then on, everyone had to identify themselves before they passed. They really morphed this into a wonderful experience. And at the very end of this session as well, the kids got together and they journaled and they sketched, some of them inside the labyrinth. Here's a view of the labyrinth at the end of the first day. I headed back to the barn and took a rest and stared at my favorite mountain. The next day, Isla and I arrived early again to get a fresh start. We poured water over the labyrinth so that we could really see the color. I was amazed at each section of rock and how there was incredible art everywhere you looked. Just the way they placed the rock and the moss, it was just so beautiful. Everywhere I turned, There was another section of the rock that just delighted me. Okay, here comes the arrival of 25 fourth through eighth graders. And these guys were in get her done mode. They were all about making it bigger and better. It went from a 16 foot by 16 foot creation to over 100 feet all the way down to the river. These guys brought huge rocks and they created moats and traps and more intricate designs. They were amazing. And just watching them was a true joy. So what you're seeing now is an entirely new entrance to the labyrinth. And what you're about to do is take a walk with me through this labyrinth. As we're walking this, I was reminded of the last night we were there. We were supposed to do a night hike at the labyrinth, but it was just too hard and too long to get down to where the labyrinth is. So instead of doing our labyrinth down at the creek, we made a human labyrinth with all the kids and then we all ran through it. It was a kick and I think they really enjoyed it because at the very end of the session, when they asked what they learned, they built themselves another human labyrinth and ran through it. It was just very cool. I was jazzed to be doing this project. I think the coolest thing about it is that none of the kids felt like they could do anything wrong. They were coloring with rocks. There was no wrong way to do it as long as they didn't hurt each other. And so they were infinitely creative without any fear at all. And that's just the best way to create. I am so grateful to have been a part of this project. First groups of kids had created a sign for the labyrinth and they spelled it incorrectly, but I didn't care. For me, it was perfectly imperfect. A group later came by and corrected the spelling. I can't help but wonder how many kids are going to try this at home. I sure hope they do.